Steam and condensate system. Steam fundamentals. Steam trap. Control valve and condensate removal. Let's discuss about steam fundamentals. Steam boiler is an enclosed vessel that provides a means for combustion and transfers heat to water until it becomes hot water or steam. The hot water or steam under pressure is then usable for transferring the heat to a process. What is steam? Steam is the technical term for water vapor, the gaseous phase of water, which is formed when water boils. Water vapor cannot be seen. Though in common language it is often used to refer to the visible mist of water droplets. Formed as this water vapor condenses in the presence of cooler air. What is condensate? Condensate is the liquid formed when steam passes from the vapor to the liquid state. In a heating process, condensate is the result of steam transferring a portion of its heat energy, known as latent heat, to the product, line, or equipment being heated. Steam is generated by adding enough heat energy to water to change it from a liquid to a gas phase. Heat energy required to accomplish this phase change. The heat in the steam can then be used to transfer heat to lower temperature surfaces. When saturated steam gives up its heat, it changes into liquid water called condensate, that is from gas to liquid phase. Let's move on to next topic. Steam trap. Steam trap is to discharge condensate, air, and other incondensable gases from a steam system while not permitting the escape of live steam. Few types of steam trap available in the market. One of it is a thermostatic steam traps. This trap sends the temperature difference between steam and subcooled condensate, air, or steam mixture. Mechanical steam traps. Float and inverted bucket traps operate by sensing the difference in density between a condensate and steam vapor. Next is thermodynamic traps. It senses the difference between the dynamic pressure of condensate at lower velocity and flash steam at higher velocity. This is most common steam trap that is used in commercial industrial plant due to its compact, simple, lightweight and have a large condensate capacity for their size. Next topic is a control valve system. A control valve is a power operated used to regulate or manipulate the flow of fluids, such as gas, oil, water, and steam. It is a critical part of a control loop and is an example of a final control element. There is various types of control valve in industry. We are going to explore some of the control valve in next slides. Two-port compression motorized valves with detachable actuator, detachable cable, and power on light. These motorized valves are the perfect solution for zoning your hot water or central heating circuits. A rotary valve is simply a mechanical device used for the continuous discharge of bulk solid materials. Globe valve can be used for regulating flow or pressures as well as complete shutoff of flow. It may also be used sometime as a pressure relief valve or as a check valve. Compared with a gate valve or ball valve, the globe valve has considerably higher pressure loss in the fully open position. Single-seated valves are one form of globe valve that are very common and simple in design. A double-seated valve is a top and bottom guided valve, and these valves have two plugs and two seats. In this type of valve, the line pressure acts upward in one plug and downward in the other, and because of this, the force is balanced. These valves are used for high-pressure applications. The purpose of a three-way control valve is to shut off water flow in one pipe while opening fluid flow in another pipe. It could be oil, steam, water, or others. To mix liquids from two different pipes into one pipe, or to separate water from one pipe into two different pipes. For three-way diverting valves, it's turning the spindle directs the flow to the left or right, upwards or downwards, depending on the orientation of the piping system. Fourth topic is discussion about condensate removal solution. Removal of condensate under all pressure conditions ensures stable temperatures. It also prevents bottom end tube corrosion and potential water hammer and freezing. Simple and efficient solution to a difficult problem without the need for expensive electrical pumps and sensors. Condensate system can be improved with this vacuum breaker. It's installed to prevent stall condition when steam pressure is insufficient to push the condensate through the steam trap. Above is the cross-sectional of vacuum breaker for our understanding. This is new and effective solution to remove condensate. Automatic pump trap is installed to prevent stall condition. When steam pressure is insufficient or higher back pressure to push the condensate towards main condensate tank. Finally, let's move on to question and answer section. Thanks to everyone to participate in this tutorial. See you guys.